Hello everybody, glad you could make it. My name is Kaylee Ellen and welcome to another video on investment houseplants. Now I do have a part one and part two video on some more beginner investment houseplants. So basically plants that cost anywhere from low treble digits to mid treble digits in that range. This video is a little bit different. This video goes from anywhere between mid treble digits all the way up to 4 digits. Now, I know those numbers seem like big numbers, but trust me when I tell you that those numbers don't even scratch the surface. So in a future video, I'm going to cover the really expensive houseplants. We're talking like several thousand and then some and then some, to be honest. So if you'd like to stick around for that content and you're not already subscribed, then feel free to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss it. If you want to make extra sure you don't miss it, there's a little bell icon that you can click. If you click that, it will send you a notification to your phone every single time I upload a video. So what actually defines a good investment houseplant? Well, I've kind of broken it up into some categories that I think are really important. The first factor is the price, which is essentially the price that you buy the plant in for. We'll call it the buy-in price. The second factor to consider is the ease or success of propagation. So how likely are the cuttings to survive if you take, say, 5 cuttings from a plant? Are they going to rot? Are they going to take off? Similarly, the time between propagations is very important because if it takes you 9 months to cut your plant and produce a new plant, the return on your investment is not as good as something else that grows a little bit quicker. Ease of care, of course, very self-explanatory. How easy is it to care for the plant in the meantime, in between all of this chopping and propping and growing them on? Market trend is a big one. So is the market trend on the plant going up? Is it going down or is it stable? This is a major factor in whether you should maybe drop a lot of cash on a plant that you may or may not get a return on. Last but not least is the availability of the plant. This is the availability for anyone to buy the plant, because a plant that is readily available is not necessarily a good plant to buy at all for a return on your cash. I have a lot to say about this houseplant. If you are unaware of what this plant is, I will show it to the camera because this one's not an easy one to show you. This here, let me tilt it, is the Monstera obliqua Peruvian form. Let's just hold that leaf there. It's nice and thin. It's in a little pot here. It's not too big a plant, but it's on its way. These plants currently, as of recording this video, range in price. For an unrooted runner node, so that's a stem with a little node on it, no roots, no nothing, that is usually around about mid treble digits. If you want to pay for a small established plant, possibly this one, possibly a little bit larger, you're into your early 4 digits. Ease or success of propagation. I'm about to say something that I know a lot of obliqua sellers are not going to like, but this plant can be propagated reasonably easy. Now, it's easy if this plant produces a runner. A runner is a stem that comes from the plant that grows a series of nodes. That runner can then be cut into pieces and rooted separately. The issue we have here is not every node on the runner will root and take off and become a plant. The success rate is not 100%, which is why if you are selling a chunk of runner without a root, without a leaf, without anything, that is not a surefire way of getting an obliqua to grow, to propagate, and to make money from. That's just a fact. Similarly, in order to get these runners to root at all, it's not the easiest thing in the world. And this is actually why you are seeing possibly a lot of people on Facebook or wherever selling runners that aren't rooted, essentially, because it's not that easy to get them going and it's not guaranteed that they will take off. I've had many a runner node that does not take off. And I've had that from my first ownership of obliqua. And I've been keeping obliqua for, I don't know, 2-3 years nonstop and selling it in my shop. So it's not a surefire bet that these runners are going to take off. Someone had to say it. I'm sorry. The good news is if you have an established plant and you produce a runner and that runner gives you, say, 20 nodes, providing you know how to get these nodes going and become small plants, you can propagate every 6 months, but you're going to have a lot of propagations out of it, theoretically. Obviously, it depends on what nodes come to life and what do not. Not every node will activate, so you must bear this in mind, but your chances of getting something, at least something, every 6 months are quite high. Ease of care, they're not the easiest plants to take care of. I have mine here in really insane conditions, and these are not the conditions that you might have in your house at home. Even some terrariums are probably not running in the conditions that I'm giving my plants. So bearing that in mind in a domestic setting, this plant can be quite difficult to care for. It's not impossible. I'm not trying to frame this as impossible, but it's definitely a higher difficulty plant. The market trend on this plant is going down. And this is primarily because sellers are selling runner chunks on whatever forum they are selling at. And that therefore drives the price down because no one wants to purchase a full plant when they believe that they can purchase a little stem for sometimes a third of the price. They think they're making a huge saving. So as a result, the sale of runner nodes has gone right up and the sale of established plants that have the ability to run has gone right down. So it's tanked the value of this plant. Availability, honestly, you can find a guy that will sell you an unrooted runner node. You can. Finding a full plant is more difficult because that is something that has grown out and it's taken a lot more time because it does take a little while to get these nodes going and turning into a plant. It's not a quick thing. So to find a full plant is a lot more difficult. Do I think the Monstera Oblica is a good investment plant? Now, while it may have been back in the day, currently, it is not. I have to say it is not. Now, because the market trend is going down, I feel like you can only really lose money if you don't know what you're doing with this plant. The only thing, in my opinion, that would bring up the market trend is if we saw less runner nodes being sold and more full plants being sold. That might bring the market trend back up. But until such time, unfortunately, this plant is on a massive, massive downturn, which is a shame because it's a really iconic plant. They're still beautiful plants. And if you want to buy one simply for yourself, they are good plants to get, but I would not advise you to get them from a unrooted piece of runner because it is not a guarantee that they will root and take off. You may well lose that runner. So if you want one of these plants, try and go for a more established option, and then you've definitely not thrown your money away and you've got more of a chance of making anything back from this plant. The next plant I'd love to talk to you about is the Monstera Adansonii variegata. Now, I feel like most people know about this plant because it's kind of everywhere on the internet, whether it's being sold somewhere or it's all over Instagram. This is an extremely popular houseplant right now. It's also extremely popular for people to buy and propagate and sell. So much so that you can probably find a one leaf cutting for as low as £200 to £300, euros, whatever have you. The price on these has really, really dropped. So if you're looking for one of these, you can probably find one. I never thought I would say this about this plant so soon, but it's honestly got to the point now where a Philodendron Florida Beauty probably costs more than this to buy. Seriously, a one-leaf cutting of this plant is probably going to be cheaper than a Florida Beauty. Who'd have thought? Ease or success of propagation? Now then. These plants do propagate easily. Obviously, there is a small chance of rot, as with everything, but they are not stable at all. I know I'm not the only person. I know a lot of people get problems when they cut the plants. If they previously have had variegation such as this, like half moon variegation, and they cut it, you can get all white, all green reversions from this plant. It is not a friendly plant to cut. So while it looks beautiful when it grows and when it's in a stable form like this, for example, this is holding really, really nice. I know for a fact, if I was to take the wonderful roots on the back of this plant here and I was to cut the plant, I would have high risk of really just not sellable variegation as an output. Time between propagation, however, is very quick. It's as little as 2 months if you really give these guys what they want. And that is probably another reason that's contributing to you seeing a lot of these around on the internet. You probably know where this is going, but the market trend on this plant has gone so far down in the past 12 months alone. This, I believe, in my opinion, has taken a lot of retailers by surprise. So shops like myself or bigger shops than me, this will have been a really nasty surprise because I know that a lot of shops were investing in these plants to propagate and build up quantities to make money from. But it seems that the private market has gone so much quicker and now these plants are borderline commercially available. Yes, it is that bad. It is that bad. This plant is bordering on not even being rare anymore. There is that much of it. With the availability being that high, because honestly, you will find one if you seek one, these are not good investment plants. They are on a massive, massive, massive downturn due to the fact that they are are easy to care for. They do grow very quick. They are very desirable. They are very affordable now. I do not personally recommend that you buy one of these to make a profit on. If you want to do it for you, if you want to give cuttings to friends and family and do it for the joy of it, then yeah, great time to buy this plant. Absolutely fantastic. If you've been holding off on buying these plants, maybe hold off a little bit longer, because I honestly think the market is unfortunately going to drop even more on them. But you will, within the next year, probably be able to get these at a really affordable price. So if you want to buy one for yourself, hold off a little bit longer, because honestly, the price is still dropping even right now. It's really taken even me by surprise, to be honest. This is the only specimen I have, and I haven't even bothered propagating from it. And the only reason that I haven't done that is because it's not a very strong variegate, I would say. Yes, there's some variegation here, but you can get better on the internet than this one. So this is my only plant, but I don't really have any need to propagate from it. I mean, I will anyway, because I can only keep plants of a certain size here, so they will get propagated and grown on from, but it will be a head cutting and it will be to continue on. I have no real interest in propagating this. It wouldn't be worth my time to propagate this and sell it. This plant is not going to be very easy to show you, so my apologies in advance, but this here is the philodendron UPI. Let me just show you this here and then rotate the plant that way, because this plant is huge. It has been cut from my mother plant. I took a head cutting as per insurance, because it's always good to do that with your plants, whether you're selling them for cash or not. So I took this head cutting, and I'm pleased to announce it's finally starting to grow. This here is a new leaf that's unfurling. It might look weird, but that's what it is. It's unfurling. So the philodendron UPI, very, very interesting plant. This plant has a price tag. This is one of the most expensive plants on this list. I will not joke about that. This plant can range for 1 to 2 thousand. And I don't know if that matches the spec that this plant is. I would say this plant was very large. So I suspect if I sold this plant, I could get more money than that. I might even be able to push it as high as 3 if I wanted to. I wouldn't, because this is a secondary plant to propagate from anyway. This plant will become a new mother, so it's going to be left to grow for a little while first. Ease or success of propagation though, let me tell you, this plant is absolutely great. I don't get failed propagations from this. Now, the internodal spacing on these is quite tight. It's not very wide, so getting in there to cut in between your internodes isn't the easiest thing in the world, but it can be done. It really just depends. Certainly when they're young, they're impossible to cut, so you're going to need a more mature plant to cut from. I've never had a problem cutting from these plants, but I have had problems on importing them in, and I thought it'd be important to mention that, because obviously if you want to buy one of these plants, you're essentially importing it. Just to let you know, I have had problems with these plants. I've had them rot on me in a weekend before, and I mean it, a weekend. I've had a plant seem fine and then literally gone. So that is something to be aware of, but if it's not a fresh import, I haven't really had any problems at all with this plant. This plant is an absolute trooper. However, slight down point, these plants do grow quite slow. And I'm saying this as someone that has a very mature one and it's very established and there are no real problems with it. It's never even been stunted for even a second and it's quite slow to grow. So if you're factoring in between propagations, it's gonna be a few months, I think. It's not very quick. This was cut, I'm not sure when. I would like to guess 3 months ago, and it's only just started to essentially give me another, you know, a leaf and root and everything else. It's taken a little while, and that is from a properly established mother plant, good conditions, good light, good feed, everything else. It's not been the quickest plant, so it will make you good money, but you're gonna be waiting for a little bit. Ease of care though, honestly guys, these plants don't give a shit. They can survive most things. They've been underwatered. They've been overwatered. They've been in a place too dark. They've been in a place too bright. They've been too hot. They've been too cold. They don't really care. This is one tough ass plant. So if you're wondering how easy they are to care for, considering the price tag, you won't have problems. Get them in a good soil. You'll be fine. They do take to lecker really well too. I should mention that. My plant upstairs is in soil. This one is in lecker and it's done absolutely fine. There's been no issues. The market trend on this plant is stable. Now this plant is not widely available. It is a massive acquired taste. It's always been a collector's item. It's just never been mainstream. So this plant has always held good value, I would say. Now in terms of availability, you are struggling. Let me tell you, you are really struggling. These plants are very difficult to find and they are not really available on the market. Plant shops don't really sell them. I rarely sell them. I only ever have a couple at a given time. It's not often. They are not an easy plant to find. So if you do find one, consider yourself very lucky, and I would probably snap at the chance because I do think that these plants are going to remain stable. I don't believe that they are going to increase on market trends just due to the acquired taste and the appearance of the plant. This isn't necessarily what everyone would classify as sexy. You feel me? It's not a heart-shaped fellow. It's not a big veiny boy. It's nothing like that. It's not necessarily going to increase, but it is stable, and you will get a nice, steady, stable return. Because this plant is highly respected among collectors. It's got a fascinating history to it, and quite a funny history, really. So I think it's a good, solid choice. If you're doing it to propagate fashionable plants, maybe not. But if you're going for the long haul, and you want a good, stable, surefire income at your own pace, there's going to be a nice, sizable return. This is a good plant to go for. I do genuinely recommend this plant. Oh, and the lack of supply alone, by the way, means this plant is a great investment plant. I'm just telling you, there's not many around. I'm probably going to have to move back for this one. This here is the gorgeous philodendron linamii. I will try and give you a little bit of a rotate so you can see how big this plant is. This is quite a big one, and I'll start by saying a lot of them on the market probably aren't quite as big as this one. This is a bit of a brute. This is my personal plant. These plants currently sell for the low end of the four-digit range, so tipping into four digits. They're not exactly cheap to get, I will say that. Ease or success of propagation, though, seriously, it's borderline guaranteed, or at least in my experience. They behave very much the same as a gloriosum. So if you don't struggle propagating that, then you won't struggle propagating this. If you do struggle propagating things like that, you will struggle propagating this. It basically behaves in exactly the same way. For me personally, that means that I don't get any failures on propagations. I have no issues at all. I find that these plants size up really well when they're propagated too, so you don't have any issues like that. You can take node chunks, you can take one leaf cuttings, you can take whatever you want. These plants are crawlers in exactly the same way that a philodendron gloriosum is. So if you're familiar with that plant, then you kind of know what you're dealing with these. I think these size up faster than gloriosum, I will say that. But they're very, very easy care. Not only that, but they're glossy. They're not velvet. So this basically means that you're just going to have less problems with pests. Pests seem to enjoy the velvet types a little bit more. They're not pest free, don't get me wrong, but you're going to have a lot less problems than maybe what you would with other velvet fellows. I would also say these plants are pretty quick. I think time between propagations is probably around about 2 to 3 months. I mean, this plant here is probably due a cut really soon. Now, I don't know if I'm going to cut from this or not. I might leave it. I might not. I might wait for it to crawl over the edge of the pot before I cut it. I kind of like how it is at the moment. But if I wanted to cut it, I completely and utterly could. It's a very, very fast growing plant. There's no problems there. So the market trend on these plants is going up. I feel like beforehand, not a lot of people knew about these plants, and now they're starting to become aware of them. Now, you might look at this plant and think, well, what's so special about that? It's a heart-shaped, it's not even velvet. Well, I can't show you on this one because it doesn't have anything new coming through yet. This is its newest leaf here, but essentially these plants have leaves that come through hot pink. Like, the whole thing is hot pink, and obviously it cools off to a green. So think of it, if you are familiar with the philodendron Florida ghost, imagine that, but pink, but a heart-shaped. So you get pink hearts and they fade to green. It's very, very collectible at the minute. So for that reason, I think the trend is on the up. They're a really, really good collector's piece. They're not for everybody. They really aren't, because some people don't really classify them as different enough from other heart shapes, but they are definitely a collector's piece and they definitely hold their value. The availability on these, it's difficult to find, but they are steadily becoming more available. This is not the same as the philodendron UPI. These ones are starting to come out a little bit more often. So your chance to make money on these is a little bit higher just due to the fact that they grow a little bit quicker and you can find them a little bit more easily. So if you wanted to get a head start on these, now is probably your time. I dare say now is probably your time, just due to how quickly they grow, just due to the fact that here and there they are kind of popping up. Do I think overall it's a good investment plant? Yes, absolutely. And that is because it's new to market and not a lot of people know about it yet. It's a heart shape, so it's going to sell anyway. Everything heart shaped always sells. It's a quick grower and I think you'll make your money back. So anything new and upcoming, I would say is very desirable and I would say is a very good bet if you want to spend the money on these and make your money back. Plus, while you're growing them, by the way, you get this absolute amazingness. And I think it's worth it just for that. Last but not least for today's video, we have the Monstera aurea. So this is a yellow variegated Monstera and it is the small form. So this is not the form of Monstera that grows, you know, really big and huge with all the massive big holes. This one stays a little bit smaller and it vines. It's a Monstera, but it's not as big as what they could be. Prices, honestly, in the UK, you can pick something up this size and this quality variegation for perhaps just under 1,000. I have seen them go for double though. I think that's probably in the US or other places, but it seems to be a little bit cheaper over here than what it is in the US. I've seen these go for 2,000. I really have. They're a bit of an it plant at the minute. They're definitely becoming so, but we'll get onto that in a moment. Ease of care. You probably saw it coming. These are more or less the same care as the Monstera Albo, the white variegated Monstera. If anything, I actually find these ever so slightly easier. The only thing I would like for you to watch out for is essentially the variegation, because this variegation is what I like to call Polaroid variegation. So when the leaf emerges, this is a great example of it here. Thank goodness, I can show you. You'll see this plant here. It does have variegation on that leaf. You probably can see it. It's got a lot, actually. It looks like this side is sectoral and this side has some speckles on it, but you can't always tell when the leaf emerges that it is variegated. So be very careful when you cut this plant and you think a leaf is all green. I've done it before and I've thrown out variegated leaves. It's not fun at all. It's really not fun at all. So be very, very careful. Ease of propagation, exactly the same as Albo. If anything, I've had slightly more success with these than Albo. I find the Albo rot on me a little bit more. I'm going to put that down to sheer luck, to be honest with you. But honestly, if you know what you're doing with Monstera Albo, this is literally no different. Depending on the size of the propagations you wish to sell, you can cut these plants as little as 2 months. Like, this wasn't long ago cut, but as soon as this shoot here sends me an aerial root, I could cut it if I wanted to. I won't, because I'm growing these more as a plant to sell, as you know, with a few more leaves on it. But if I wanted to, I could cut that. So these plants do grow very, very quick. The only thing you need to watch out for when you're propagating this plant is basically the leaves are going to come out juvenile. So if you cut your mother plant and you get a new leaf come out of, you know, after you've cut it, that's going to be juvenile. If you cut these, it's going to continue to be juvenile. They really need a good root system in order to size up. And when they are cut, they do revert to juvenile for a bit. Luckily, that doesn't seem to put anybody off buying these plants. Everyone seems more than happy to buy a plant like this in juvenile form that doesn't have any fenestrations or holes or anything like that. So it won't affect anything. It's just if you were expecting to sell big, beautiful, you know, leaves with splits in, it's probably not going to happen unless you cut from a really mature plant and then you wait longer and then you cut again from a really mature leaf. Ease of care is the same as the Albo. To get a bit more yellow on your plant, just bump the light a little bit more and the variegation will harden off to a nice yellow shade instead of a lime green. If you don't give them enough light, they will go lime green. You can get it back simply by putting it in more light, but just a little FYI, because I've seen it happen and it used to happen to me before I bumped my light as well. Market trend is on the up. I'm so pleased to be able to tell you this. This plant is starting to become, ever so slowly but surely, it's starting to become the new Albo. We all know what Albo is like. It's becoming more available. This plant is not. This plant is less available. In fact, I struggle to see it other than a cutting on the internet. And even then, the variegation isn't necessarily really strong. So you do have a couple of quality issues there. But in terms of market trend, this is on the up. It really is. The price has gone up as well in recent months. I've seen it go up myself. It wasn't always 1,000 for a small plant. It has gone up. My prices have gone up because the demand has gone up. I will say that I have noticed that more and more people are starting to catch on to this very early on, and that's probably because they have a good barometer of this because of the Albo. So I am seeing a lot of people holding back plants to propagate them and get higher numbers of them, which you will see them leaked. You'll have seen them here and there on the internet. It's happening. It's just not happening very quickly, and I suspect a lot of growers are going to keep these back to get larger quantities before they are leaked. So if you want one of these plants, your best bet is probably to go for a private seller, or if you find it on a shop, great, but get a cutting and just start from there. Just get a good cutting with good variegation, as we've covered earlier. Do I think it's a good investment? Unbelievably so. It could be one of the best ones on this list because it's Monstera deliciosa, and who doesn't love Monstera deliciosa? It's a universal favorite in the houseplant world, let alone the aroid world. The houseplant world loves Monstera deliciosa. So this can't really fail, especially with the market trend going up as well. If you can get your hands on one of these, I highly suggest you do so. You will make a pretty nifty return. If I could pick a favorite from this list to invest in, let me look at the other things I mentioned. It's this one. This is probably the best one on the list, in my opinion, to invest in. And that was it for this video. Now, before you comment, I am well aware that there are a lot of plants that would fit into this price bracket that I have left out. And that is because I will feature them in another video. I find that if I do more than 5 in these videos, they can get a bit longer. Despite me trying to shorten the videos every time, it's not really working. So we'll do them in 5s, and I will be releasing another video in the future on some more plants that I would consider to be in this price bracket. What I think, are they good investments? So please stay tuned for that and hit that subscribe button if you'd like to see them. Similarly, I will be doing, at some given point, I will be doing a video on basically the insanity plants that you can purchase. Plants that I don't think everyone knows exist. Really, really big guns. And that could be a very interesting video. I feel like at that point, the prices and the investment opportunities are theoretical because honestly, some of the people investing in those, they've got some serious cash. Like it's not games anymore. Do you know what I mean? But I would love to cover them in a video because I think it'd be very, very interesting to sit and talk about them and make everyone aware of them. Until such time, thank you very much for watching this video. Please leave a like, leave a comment, and hit that subscribe button. It lets me know I'm doing a fab job of running my mouth talking about investment plants. That's it, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.